Hey guys, it's your faith girl, and I am so excited you have made the decision to join me and tune in for this very special Success and Celibacy series. Now, this series is based upon my book, Success and Celibacy, which can be found on my website at shayscottedwards.com, as well as these fabulous Faith Rocks t-shirts. So get into the movement. We really just are here to inspire you to incorporate faith into every aspect of your life. Now, this includes your sex life. It's no secret that God desires us to maintain celibacy, to abstain from sex until marriage. I understand, you know, the times we live in, it makes it super hard to live a life in accordance with God's will. So that's why I wrote this book for you. It's a shorthand guide meant for the young professional on the go that doesn't have a lot of time to. You already know, in order to be successful in any area of life, you need to identify your why, because it is the why that's going to keep you on the rough days. It's the why that's going to keep you when you're ready to throw in the towel, when it doesn't make sense, when you're tempted, and when everything in the world is telling you to just give up. But if you have a solid why, you're going to hang in there. Now, for me personally, while conviction prompted me, you know, and really sort of gave me that push to say, you know what, I'm done with feeling depressed, I'm done with feeling shame, I'm done with feeling unfulfilled from these sexual encounters. But it was the love of God and embracing the love that God had for me first, and then the love that I had for Him, that really carried me through until the end. So, I encourage you to. So when we think about the love of God, we think about God's unconditional love for us, that He loved us so much that He gave His life for us. We know that anything He asks of us is for our highest good. God loves you so much that He is asking you to abstain so that you don't have to go through hardship, so you don't have to endure the consequences of sin. When you think about and when you spend time meditating about the all-encompassing love of God, you will start to realize that God is the only being and spirit that loves you more than you can ever love yourself. He loves you more than any human relationship, your mother, your father, your husband, your child. God's love is so great that we could never even fathom it. And He is such a good and loving Father that we have to get to the point where we trust that His will is for our highest good, and that He's asking us to maintain a celibate lifestyle because He's protecting us out of a place of love, that He's asking us to wait because He loves us, and we express our love for Him by obeying Him. As a matter of fact, John 14 and 15 says, "If you love me, keep my commandments." That is the way we show our appreciation, and our part in our relationship with God is by obeying Him and keeping His commandments. But I want to caution you to not be like me, and don't do this out of a place of selfish ambition. God loves you so much. He has your entire life planned out for you. He's already ordered your steps. The steps of a righteous man are already ordered. So for me, when I first got into this, I was like, okay, if I do this for you, God, you're going to open up doors for my acting career. That's what I'm believing you for. I'm believing you for a husband, and I'm believing for you to bless me because I'm being obedient. I'm doing something that not many people are doing or have the discipline to do. So I'm special. Therefore, you should bless me. It's all, that is totally the wrong motive to have. Now, God loved me through that, but He showed that He wants our love for Him to be reason enough to obey Him. So allow your love for God be the thing that ushers you into celibacy and that keeps you on your wagon. That love is enough. That love is so pure, the love that He has for us, that He doesn't need us to give Him timelines or give Him stipulations. All He needs us to do is to obey Him and to trust Him. So if you're standing on that foundation of love, of understanding that God loves you unconditionally and God wants to preserve your mind, body, and soul, and He wants to save you for the appointed time, then it makes it a little bit easier to, you know, stay on the wagon. It makes it a little bit easier on those nights that you just want a warm body and you just want someone to give you physical pleasure or to, you know, just keep you company. So know that God loves you so much and allow that love of God to fill you up. No relationship, no sexual encounter is going to fill you up like the love of God. We all know this. You know it, and God doesn't want us to have to learn this the hard way, but stop seeking people and relationships and sex to fill a void that only God can fill. And this love for God is going to help you love yourself and boost your self-esteem in ways that you never even imagined. When we get to the point where we accept God's love and we accept God's grace, not condemnation. There's no condemnation for those of us who are in Christ Jesus. So let that go. You know, let go of the shame, let go of the guilt. Once you've repented, you are free to just accept and take on God's love and grace and be pure in heart, be pure in your actions, be pure in your lifestyle, because it's gonna take away a lot of stress. It's going to take away a lot of heartache. It's going to take away a lot of pain and shame. So God is all about saving us from ourselves, saving us from our mistakes, saving us from the consequences of sin and some of the poor choices that we make. So just allow love to be your guiding force and your foundation. Mark 12 and 30 says, "And you should love the Lord God with all of your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, and with all your strength. This is the first commandment." If you're having a hard time wrapping your mind around why celibacy, I know God wants me to do this, but what's going to keep me going? You know, why do I have to do this? Just focus on the love. Focus on the fact that you are so loved. You are so worthy that God wants this for you because he wants you to start living your best life because he loves you and you are free to love him. We love God because he loved us first and he's called you into this relationship with him. He's calling you into obedience. And so I am so proud of you. Congratulations. You know, it's not easy, but with God, it gets easier and easier. And when you're standing on a foundation of love in your relationship with God, it's going to empower your self-esteem. It's going to empower all of your other relationships. It's going to get your priorities in order. And, you know, in the book, I give you affirmations and I give you scriptures to stand on that are going to help you along this process also. So if you haven't already, get the Celibacy. So this book is going to give you everything you need to just think about your relationship. Think about your love for God. Think about how you can express that and think about the fact that it is worth it. And God is so worth your love, your obedience, and your affection. And he has awesome, awesome things in store for you. So don't allow sin and sex and premarital sex to be a stumbling block for you anymore. Just stand on God's love. Keep tuning in to the Success and Celibacy series. Leave me a comment in the box below with your questions, your concerns, your struggles, so I know what to bring you in this series. If you need prayer, email me at slsworldwide@gmail.com. And I would love to be there for you. So thank you so much for tuning in. Please share Faith Rocks with your girlfriends, with your guy friends, with anybody in need of a faith lift or who is interested in, you know, becoming celibate and thinks they can't do it or has been celibate for a while and could use just a little encouragement to be enthusiastic about it again. I'm here for you. So tune in, follow me on Instagram and Facebook and Twitter. All the details are in the box below, and subscribe to this video, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.